like, we see you and you can't see yourself. And that part is like really weird and fucked up.
I've been going through it all.
Yeah.
Back all against the wall. Trying hard not to fall.
Yeah.
All I wanted was to ball.
Right.
I've been going through it all.
Welcome back to my channel or whatever. I post a lot on my Instagram at the Hood Hippie about being in therapy. If you guys don't follow me, please check out my Instagram. Some days I'm hood and some days I'm hippie. Today I'm gonna talk a little bit more about my hippie side, which is my side that's really focused on healing the past traumas that I've been through. When you are going through like life, you will naturally experience trauma, some of us more severe than others. I've had a very traumatic childhood and upbringing. It has taken me a lot of time to take accountability for my part in that, to let go of other parts that are not mine, and to be able to walk and make different decisions and cancel generational curses, so that when I choose to have children, that I do not pass those unhealthy traits down to my children. Therapy is a safe space to process life. You do not have to have a bunch of anxiety or like a bunch of depression, or you don't have to have like a condition to go to therapy. The way that I've chosen about to go about my healing has been a lot of different ways, you know, at different stages in my life. Sometimes it was church, and sometimes it was going to the club. And right now at 30, it's therapy. Throughout life, I personally believe that you will be right where you need to be at all times to learn what you need to learn. I am fortunate enough to be able to afford to go to therapy, and I feel like most people can't afford it if you make it a priority, and I've made it a priority. Trust me, when I first started going to therapy, I was like, bitch, you want me to pay $150 to talk to you? Bitch, I could talk to people for free. Like, the fuck? Things kind of changed for me. My mindset about it kind of shifted from like a bill to like a self-care need, the same way I feel about my eyelashes. Blink, blink. I do not take breaks from my eyelashes anymore because I know that that is something that I need to feel good about myself. It enhances my natural beauty. And the same thing about, I feel the same way about therapy. It enhances my communication. It enhances my outlook on life. I started going to therapy in 2017. I've had the same therapist for the past 2 years. I was fortunate enough to only have to go to one therapist. Like, we were just destined to work together. We just vibed. I had too much coffee one day, and I started Googling and calling phone numbers. I have really bad anxiety, and coffee just like puts it to the next level. I still love coffee though, bitch. I am a gold Starbucks member, okay? I mean, one day I'll get tired of putting myself through that and I'll stop drinking coffee. Today's not that day though, sis. I had me a caramel cloud macchiato earlier today and it was bomb. Anyway, like I said, I found my therapist online. Psychology Today is a great resource. If you're a black girl, Therapy for Black Girls is a great resource. My therapist has a network. Healing Color is a great resource if you're looking for women of color. I recommend that you take just as much time with finding a therapist as you do with finding a partner. You know what I'm saying? You're interviewing this person to see if you guys are on the same vibe, like if you guys can work together. I was like very nervous. It was like something that I wanted to do, but I also like, I had such a negative outlook on therapy at the same time. So I was like a little iffy about it. So I filled out the Psychology Today and I was like, I would like help with my mental health or something. Like, I didn't give any details. And she called me, which I didn't expect. I don't know why. I thought everything was gonna be via email. It was not. She called me immediately and was like, I think she emailed me and was like, hey, can I set up some time to talk? So she called me just to see if it was gonna be a good fit. And she kind of asked me why I was coming, had I ever been, do I have insurance? Like all these questions, just basically like the same shit you would do the first time you go to a new doctor, a physical doctor. She was like, okay, well, let's schedule a 1 hour consultation. Most therapy sessions are about 45 minutes to an hour, 45 minutes max, and they give you a 15 minute buffer. So they have to write notes and keep up with your file and shit afterwards before their next client comes in. But your first session is probably like an hour because you have to fill out paperwork, they have to go through the paperwork, and they need to hear your story, right? So the first session, we kind of went through like confidentiality and like how that works. Like basically it's between me and you, unless you kill somebody or you tell me some shit that you ain't supposed to be doing, like touching babies or like you finna kill a bitch tomorrow. Then the confidentiality goes out the fucking window. You have to fill out this checklist. Like, have you ever been sexually assaulted, or have you ever suffered with anxiety or depression, or do you feel moody a lot? Like, you literally fill out this long ass piece of paper with like checklist. You do it before your first session, and then when you get there, you go, you talk through it with her. And so she'll say like, oh, like what's up with that, and like why'd you check that box? And then you'll give them your broken fake ass answer, which is what I did, which is just like, yeah, but that wasn't nothing, you know, it was whatever, but whatever. And they take notes, they say, okay, you know, at least my therapist, and she was like, okay, cool. So we went through my whole life story, and at the time, like, I was so disconnected from my emotions that I could tell you my whole traumatic ass like upbringing without zero connection to the story. And in fact, probably be laughing, because that's how I cope with when I'm uncomfortable. I typically crack a joke, or I laugh, or avoid the subject altogether. That's my fave. But yeah, the first session is actually pretty okay. Like, it wasn't as bad as I thought it was gonna be, and I left there feeling like, okay, I'm doing something with my life. Still a hot mess, but you know, I didn't realize it at the time. It's hindsight is 2020, and that shit is real. Like, over the years, it's been 2 years now, I laugh at the hood hippie that walked through her doors 2 years ago. Like, who were you, bitch? Like, what were you doing? Who are you fooling? Only yourself, sis. That's it. Everyone else sees right through you in that trauma. It's manifesting in everything that you do. And I focused a lot for the first like 6 to 8 months on processing my last relationship and processing the potential of a new relationship. I didn't spend a lot of time talking about myself. I spent a lot of time talking about my relationships with other people, whether it was family members, partners, exes. It wasn't about me. Like, it's 2 years later, and I'm just now getting to a place where I'm ready to talk about me. I learned through those relationships things about myself. I learned that I don't communicate well. I thought I was. I learned that by not speaking up and like not saying how I feel about things and just letting everything be, oh, it's okay, it's fine, everything's great, that actually does not help the relationships. It doesn't help pretending to be super save a hoe, like super save a hoe for so long. Like, that's just what I knew because of the way that I was raised. I felt like in order for someone to love me, I had to like try to help them, try to save them, because that's how people loved me. I'm just here to help you, and like, I don't need anything, I'm just here. No, I have feelings, I have wants, I have needs, and I was not able to like say that. I wasn't able to be like, hey, that hurt my feelings. Like, it took me so long to be able to say that, and it would manifest in like other things. You see this with couples all the time. I'm not even talking about relations right now, I'm just talking about like in my life. Like, a person will like take so much, and then they blow up over like a Fanta. You know, you spilled the Fanta in my car, and now like we in jail because I didn't cut a bitch. I learned healthy coping mechanisms. I learned to recognize my triggers. I've learned that I have anxiety, and I have to not put myself in situations that I will continue to increase my anxiety. I was depressed at the time. I learned I have seasonal depression, so that comes and goes. Every winter I get really depressed. When the sun goes down at 5 o'clock, it's not good for your girl, because whatever. But this year we know that I have seasonal depression, so we will be putting in like coping mechanisms and ways to process through that seasonal depression to avoid it being as bad as it normally is. I learned a lot of what my triggers are. Having boundaries, I learned about boundaries. Like, hey, you can't come and go as you please. You must come when I say you can come, and you can go when I say you can go. Those are my boundaries. You know, you can't come and go in my life as it willy-nilly. You know what I'm saying? You can't talk to me any kind of way. You can't treat me any kind of way. Like, I have boundaries. Like, that's new. I'm just very thankful for therapy. I think that at this phase of my life, like I said, I'm 30. This tool has been, and that's exactly what it is, right? It's a tool. It's a safe space to say those thoughts out loud and bounce them back and hear yourself speak and be like, oh, that's not what I meant. It sounded better in my head, but then when you think, you're like, oh, I don't really need to be thinking that because that's not the truth. You know what I'm saying? Like, I said something the other day Actually, I said this to my girlfriend, who is a therapist, by the way. So sometimes she reflects back to me what I say. And I'm like, oh, okay, you're right. I was like, yeah, nobody cares about me that hard. Da-da-da. I was in my feelings. Nobody cares. Nobody loves me. And da-da-da-da. And she was like, something. And I was like, well, that's not what I meant for real. You know, like, that's not what I'm saying. And she was like, well, you got to choose your words better then, because that's what you said. And I'm like,
oh. All
right. Words are powerful. They are life and they are death. And your thought patterns and your thought process will manifest in your life, whether it's negative or positive. I don't care if you believe it or not. It's fact. Any religion teaches you this. Christianity, Buddhism, the Quran, maybe. I don't know. My girlfriend's Muslim. Maybe I should ask. I'm pretty sure she's gonna say, yeah, girl. We all believe in the law of attraction, the fucking secret. You know what I'm saying? Like, speak those things that be not as though they were. You know what I'm saying? You call it down from the heavens. I'm claiming it. You know, you see people in church like claiming money, invisible money. It's all the same thing. So, you know, I just really love going to therapy and getting the shit off my chest and like knowing that she genuinely cares and like she listens to me. That's a big thing. A lot of people don't listen because we're all like wrapped up in our own shit so much that you listen to your homies and you give them your jaded perspective on what you think they should do about whatever the case may be. But when you're paying someone to listen to you, they listen, honey. They will. There is no distractions. And even something I love about therapy is I'm literally forced to sit in a room for an hour, 45 minutes to an hour, complete silence. There's no, she may have like a white noise machine in the background, just for confidentiality, but there's no noise, there's no electronics, there's no phone, there's no TV, there's no social media, there's no distraction, it's just us. And sometimes I don't have anything to say, so we'll just sit in silence until something comes out. You know what I'm saying? Like, every time I go, it's not deep, it's not like sad, but when things happen, as things happen in life, when I'm stressed about whatever, she's there and it works out. And if it wouldn't be her, it'd be somebody else. Like, therapy is great. Everyone should go, but it's not as scary as a lot of people make it seem. Therapy has a bad rap. It has a bad rap, especially in the Black community. You know, I have my video, I'll link that down below as well. The 5 myths, or was it 5 or 10? Anyway, 5 to 10 myths about therapy, especially in the Black community. You know, to this day, I tell my grandparents I'm going to therapy and they like, what you going to therapy for? Bitch, you crazy? Like, I'm crazy to them. I am insane to my family because I'm like, oh no, that's not okay. I don't like that. Like, I'm able to say, oh no, that's not okay. That's not cool. You're manipulating me right now. You're gaslighting me right now. I don't appreciate that. I don't participate in that. I need this. And that is like really jarring to a lot of people, that I know what I need and I'm able to communicate that to others. I know what I will take and I know what I will not take. I know my worth, I know my value, and don't waste my motherfucking time, period. I've learned this with growing up. Age is clearly a factor, but mostly with therapy. Just being like, bitch, you deserve. I deserve. Is that Mama D song? I recommend everybody go check it out. I know I rambled a lot in this video, but I just really wanted to get the importance of people taking time and space for themselves. It is okay to take space for yourself. It's okay to put up boundaries and walls to protect, not walls, excuse me, boundaries. Boundaries are just like, think of a wall with a door and you choose who comes in and who comes out, versus like a wall is like it doesn't have a door and it's just like you're blocked off from the rest of the world. That's not the case. I am drama free. I am happy. I am loved. I am peace. I am light. Thank you so much for this space, YouTube. Thank you for watching my videos and you know, I just love vibing with y'all and it's been all good vibes. Thank you to my subscribers. I'll be back with more videos, whether it's the hood or the hippie, girl. You never know what you're gonna get. Bye guys, see you next time. Thanks.